People obsess over him like he's some kind of god.
Well, most of Tim Burton films, what I've watched anyway, are all dark and like gothic kind of looking. But like, it's like kind of a sepia look.
Surely you must a little.
Of course not.
Get those corsets laced properly. I can hear you speak without gasping.
My favourite Tim Burton film must be Edward Scissorhands, because it's the dark grittiness of, you know, Johnny Depp with scissors in his hands, the dark horror. And I managed to get a PG rating after all.
The tools of filmmaking have changed over the years, obviously. I mean, I try to keep the same approach, where you try to keep it as hands-on and handmade and homemade as you can. Because I just feel like that is something that I always, you know, I liked having actors and sets and having limitations that you have to deal with. That's what makes it fun.
Tim Burton has more of a dark life and death comparison between life and death.
Again, that kind of dark feel that's still kind of light-hearted is kind of an interesting mix.
Life and death running at the same time.
Like a kind of storytelling feel. Like, it's not there to kind of blow the audience, well, blows the audience's mind in a way that's kind of so over-stylized. But it's kind of still more about the mood of it and stuff. Quentin Tarantino, it's kind of all kind of, it's quite in your face.
You just see loads of unneeded gore.
Quentin Tarantino has everyday life.
Tim Burton's work is kind of in your face in a way, but it's still definitely about storytelling rather than blockbuster action.
Quentin Tarantino usually does like gangster films, people wanting to kill people, whereas Tim Burton does more about life and death, the underworld coming to the living world.